Curtis sacks last year. Could this defensive line be better? I think so. And I think by a mile. I'll tell you how. Yo, that.
A. G. L. E. S.
Eagles! Eagles!
Say fly, Eagles, fly.
Fly, Eagles, fly.
Fly, Eagles, fly.
Yo, that man, you know who it is, you know what it is, your boy Fully Fresh, aka The General, also a fourth, yes, a fourth for the Battle Bird Podcast. If you have not done it, please make sure you hit that sub button down there for your boy, man. I appreciate it. And also, make sure it's a bell next to it to let you know when I put up all this flavor. And also, smash the like for your boy, man. That's how my content gets pushed out there. That's how people get to see what I'm doing. You know what I mean? Because of y'all. And I appreciate every last one of y'all. And yes, you know, if you want to get some Philly Fresh merch and also the Yo That merch, we got hats, we got buckets, we got hoodies, we got shirts. Whatever your flavor is, just let me know and I'll get it. If I ain't got it, I'ma get it. If I can't get it, I'ma get it while the getting is good. Something like that. You get what I'm trying to say. All right. It would be in the description, though, if you want to know how to purchase some of the Philly Fresh Yo That / Yo That merchandise. And members, yes, members, I will be trying to get with y'all Monday. Trying to get a time. So if you have my DMs or whatever, hit me up, let me know. All the members, man. We're gonna try to do a live, man. We're gonna try to talk about the season. We're gonna try to pick a just pick a record. We just gonna have some fun. Y'all know how we get down. All right. Fresh fact of the day. Y'all know I do this all the time, man. Be careful what you say around the people that follow you. Be careful what you do around the people that follow you. See, here's the thing. A lot of parents, and, you know, I can say guilty of this sometimes too, but a lot of parents, they grind their kids up about this and doing that and saying this and smoking and yada, yada, yada. But where they brought up with that mentality, where they brought up seeing that in the household, where they brought up always, you know, you, your baby mom, your baby father always yelling and cussing at each other. And now they adopted that. And then when they go out in the streets, it's just like, oh, well, they do it out here too. Oh, this is just life. So if they slip up and they cuss, now you want to beat them. And now you want to, you know, strangle them or whatever the case may be. Nah, it's a lot of times that's your fault. A lot of kids are sponges, man. They soak up everything that you give out, man. Well, not everything, obviously. But they soak up a lot of, especially negative stuff for some reason. Kids just soak that stuff up. So just be aware, man. You know, that's just for the parents out there. You already know. All right. Let's get to the video. Can this defensive line be better than it was last year? Remember, last year we was third in sacks. Yes. Third in sacks without, what was it like? We blitzed like 12% of the time or something without really any blitzes. Without any blitzes, without using a Janar Avery, how he should be used as one of them wildcat type of linebackers. Without none of that. You know what I mean? Without Hargrave being put in his proper spot that I think he's being put there over the B gap, not the A gap. Two gap, three gap, whatever. I mean, one or two gap, whatever you want to call it. All right. So when you look at it and you break everything down that happened last year, yes, the only person that we really lose is Malik Jackson. That is a loss. But Malik has not, and we try to use him inside and outside like we're doing a Milton Williams. And I'm not going to go out on a limb and say it because it's only preseason, but it looked like he's doing better than Malik. It looked like he's doing better than Malik Jackson last year. And I think he has a chance to do better this year than Malik Jackson did for us last year. Then you got Josh Sweat. Derek Barnett stays with a shoulder situation. I don't know what's going on with that, but we already know. So you still do got John Sweat and Brandon Graham. They're your starters. Right now, the season started right now. Brandon Graham and John Sweat are your starters, and I've been told y'all this. Then you got some rotational players. You got Fletcher Cox. You got Hargreave. You got Milton Williams, who I think is not the key, because we all know Fletcher Cox is the key to the defense. But he's a guy, if you don't miss a beat when Fletcher Cox come off, not really a beat. You're always going to miss a beat. But you get what I'm saying. If you still get a guy that's just relentless, that I see a Milton Williams is, and creative with his moves, swing moves, spin moves, up and unders. Like when you really break down the tape of this kid can get busy. And I understand why he took a number three now. And I told y'all that Howie Roseman's draft is going to depend on whether Milton Williams can be a, not starter, but a guy that you're looking at in the future and saying, you're the future of the defensive line. Think about it. Because we all know Fletcher Cox is not getting any younger. And I have grinded Fletcher Cox up, but at the same time, I don't think Jim Schwartz did anything to help his defensive line. It was just go eat. And if you can't get at the quarterback, oh well. Not no help, not no blitzes, not no stunts, not none of that. It was just so manila. I don't think Jonathan Gannon is with that. I think that now, give or take, this is preseason, so we haven't seen exactly what they're going to do. But what we have seen is that this defensive line, no matter who they play, is a brute force. Now, it wasn't that way against the Patriots in a game. Cam Newton just looked like, and it's crazy. I see ESPN and Cam Newton with 8 or 9. And come on, man. We doing a Sam Bradford thing. Preseason Sam Bradford. Remember he went like 11 of 11 or something like that. And everybody was talking about, come on, stop it. But anyway, they couldn't get no pressure. But you do realize it was the third strings out there. Now, Milton Williams was out there and he was getting pressure, but it wasn't enough. You can't do it by yourself. But the rest of the line ain't there. So if you got Milton Williams and a Brandon Graham and a Fletcher Cox and a Hargreave and a Josh Sweat, watch out. And let's not forget, we got Kerrigan. Did you forget about that? Yo, this defensive line, man, is going to be scary. It's going to scare the NFC East and whoever we play. Seriously, I understand they talk about Washington, yada, yada, yada. I get it. I understand. Yeah, they can be had, though. But I ain't going to lie. I'm proud of what Howie Roseman has put together with this defensive line. And if it all comes together, this is going to be a scary team to go against. Because we all know it starts with getting pressure on the quarterback. If you pressure the quarterback, all things fall. All things fall down. Let me know what y'all think in the comments, man. I just had to talk about this defensive line. They are showing up. They were showing up and showing out in camp. And it looks like that they're going to be the position to look at. We all know what Cuz Watkins is doing. You know what I mean? Appreciate him. They said he came up big again today. We're going to talk about that tomorrow, though. But today, I got to get a defensive line in flowers. Let me know what y'all think in the comments. Y'all already know. Stay Philly. Stay fresh, y'all. Yo, that.